This video will cover the mathematical aspects of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. For a more conceptual overview of Hardy-Weinberg, including the five conditions for Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, check out our last video. Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is a mathematical model used to describe a population that's not evolving. Besides the five conditions that we discussed in our last video, there are certain limitations to Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. And in order for the Hardy-Weinberg model to be used, these conditions have to be met. Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium can only be applied if we're dealing with a genetic trait that's controlled by just one gene, and that gene also has to have exactly two alleles controlling it. One of those alleles has to be completely dominant over the other recessive allele, and that's just the standard basic pattern of inheritance that we all know. But it's important to note that in nature, these conditions are actually really hard to meet, since a lot of traits are controlled by more than one gene, and many genes have way more than two alleles controlling them. And that's why Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is mostly used as a hypothetical scenario that's more of a baseline for predicting allele frequencies. So now that we know the limitations, let's talk about the equations. There are two main equations for Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. P squared plus 2pq plus q squared equals 1, and p plus q equals 1. So before we take a deeper look at the equations as a whole, let's first talk about each variable individually. In the equations, p represents the frequency of the dominant allele, and q represents the frequency of the recessive allele. P squared represents the frequency of the homozygous dominant genotype, and q squared represents the frequency of the homozygous recessive genotype. Lastly, 2pq represents the frequency of the heterozygous dominant genotype. In order to understand this better, let's use the example of a butterfly species. Let's say a species of butterflies comes in two possible colors, red and blue. The red color is dominant to the blue color, which is recessive. So we can represent the red butterfly by using the allele big R and represent the blue butterfly by using the allele little r. Since the red color is dominant, the genotypes big R and big R little r will lead to a red-colored butterfly, since we only need one dominant allele to have the dominant genotype and phenotype. Only the genotype little r will lead to a blue-colored butterfly. So if we go back to the equations for Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, the frequency of the big R allele, which is our dominant allele, can be represented by p, so the frequency of our recessive allele, little r, can be represented by q. The genotype big R can be represented by p squared, since that's the homozygous dominant genotype, and so the genotype little r can be represented by q squared, since it's the homozygous recessive genotype. Lastly, the heterozygous genotype, big R little r, can be represented by 2pq. Let's try an example problem using the same butterfly species. Suppose we're given that the frequency of the recessive genotype little r is 0.36. Using this, we're asked to find all the other frequencies, given that all the conditions of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium are met. So for the first part, we must find the frequency of the little r allele. So let's first identify what variable we're looking for. We have to find the frequency of little r, and since we know that little r is the recessive allele, we know that we're looking for q. And the problem tells us also that the frequency of the homozygous recessive genotype is 0.36. So if we go back to the chart, we know that that's referring to q squared, which is the homozygous recessive genotype. So we know that q squared is equal to 0.36, and we know that we're looking for q. So to find the frequency of the recessive allele, all we have to do is take the square root of q squared and find q to be 0.6. The next part of the question asks for the frequency of the dominant allele. Since we're looking for the dominant allele frequency, we know that we're looking for p. So now let's write down everything that we know from the previous parts. We solved for q and we were given q squared. So to find p, we need to use an equation. The equation p plus q equals 1 will help us solve for p. All we have to do is rearrange the equation and substitute the value for q, and we find that p is equal to 0.4. Next, we need to find the frequency of the big R genotype. Based on the chart, this is the homozygous dominant genotype, which is p squared. We already found p to be 0.4, so all we have to do is square p to find p squared, which is 0.16. For the next part, we need to find the frequency of the big R little r genotype, which is the heterozygous genotype, and that is equal to 2pq. All we have to do is plug in the values for p and q, and we find that 2pq is equal to 0.48. Finally, the last part asks how many butterflies are in each genotype. Before, we solved for all the frequencies, but now we need to find the exact number of butterflies within each genotype. And the problem already tells us that the total population of butterflies is 100. So we have the genotypes listed here, so all we have to do is multiply the frequency of each genotype by the total number of individuals in the population. And after doing this, we find that there are 16 butterflies with the genotype big R, big R, 36 butterflies with the genotype little r, little r, and 48 butterflies with the heterozygous genotype big R, little r. So here's a recap of the equations and what each variable means. P and Q represent the frequency of the dominant and recessive allele respectively, and P squared and Q squared represent the frequency of the homozygous dominant and recessive genotypes respectively, and lastly, 2PQ represents the frequency of the heterozygous dominant genotype. And those are all the basics that you need to know about the mathematical model of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium.